want to use aseptic technique to make new subcultures of bacteria from existing subcultures. We will be using the bacteria Bacillus subtilis. The process of aseptic technique is moving a microorganism from one location to the other and preventing contamination of either the existing subculture, the new subculture, your surroundings, yourself, or any other place that you do not want the microorganism. The only microorganism that should end up in the location you're transferring into is the one that you intend to, which in this case is Bacillus subtilis. You will be learning how to do three different subcultures today. You will be transferring some from a Bacillus subtilis broth that you are provided with to a new broth to make a new subculture of Bacillus subtilis and a nutrient broth. You will be taking a Bacillus subtilis slant, an existing culture, and making a new slant of Bacillus subtilis. And you will be using a Bacillus subtilis plate, outer plate, nutrient outer plate, to make a new nutrient outer plate of Bacillus subtilis. So the equipment used in this technique, first of all, is one of them is called an inoculating loop, okay, which is a metal handle, and there is a wire at the end that has a loop. It must be a continuous loop or it will not hold a drop of bacteria. If it's broken for any reason, you need to get a new one. Okay, you will hold that like a pencil. Do not hold it like a bat. You cannot control it well this way. You need to hold it gently like a pencil. Okay, and that way you can control it very well. The other piece of equipment that's very important in this technique is a Bunsen burner. Okay, and the striker to start it. So a Bunsen burner, there are many different types, but they're all basically the same. You will turn on the gas, use the striker to start it, and then adjust the flame. The flame should be about 1.5 to 2 inches tall. Not any more than 2 inches because you do not need a large flame and it's dangerous. There's two ways to adjust the flame to get a blue flame that is 1.5 to 2 inches tall. You use the bottom dial to adjust how much gas, and that will adjust the height of the flame. And you use the collar that will allow a certain amount of air or not get no air in. And that is how you adjust it to be a blue flame, which will be hotter. Okay, so make sure that your wire at the end of your inoculating loop is straight. Okay, sometimes the loop at the end can be bent up a little bit, kind of like a hockey stick, because it'll be easier to skate along the outer surface. As you go along, you may find that. Okay, so the first transfer, we are using an existing Bacillus subtilis broth. Okay, it's in a glass test tube. You'll see that it's got writing on it, tells you what's in it. You always handle test tubes by the glass, never by the lid. The lids are not tight. It can come off, it will drop onto your foot and break. Okay, onto the floor and make a mess that you will have to clean up. Okay, so always handle tubes by the glass. You have a new sterile nutrient broth that you will transfer some of the Bacillus to make a new culture. When labeling a tube, very important, you must label the name of the microorganism, which in this case is Bacillus subtilis, the date, and your initials. Okay, those three pieces of information must be on any culture you make. They're very important in case somebody needs to know it's in a tube and you are not around. Never ever label the lid. The lids can move to another tube and then they will be inaccurate. You always label the glass. You always handle the tube by the glass. Okay, so to do this transfer from broth to broth, you have your inoculating loop. You will sterilize it, called flaming the loop. So sterilize your loop until it's red hot. Remove it after a few seconds. Pick up the existing culture of Bacillus subtilis. Make sure you're holding it by the glass. Grasp the lid with your little finger, the same hand that's holding the inoculating loop. This can be a little tricky at first, but you'll get the hang of it. Take the lid off, flame the top of the tube just for a few seconds. Don't burn your fingers. This is still hot, even though you've had it out of the flame for a few seconds. So you don't want to stick it right into the broth. It can sizzle and spit and shoot spitting bacteria in your face. So first of all, make sure you're facing the opening the tube away from your face. And then when you put this loop into the tube, cool it on the side before you get to the liquid. Okay, that way it'll be less hot when it hits the liquid. It may still sizzle a little bit, but it won't sizzle as much, and please make sure it's not facing your face anyway. Go into your culture and get a loop full of bacteria. You'll see that there is liquid inside the loop now. Flame the top of the tube again, put the lid on, and set it down. Okay, so now you have your loop full of bacteria to transfer to the new broth. Pick up the new broth, flame the top. Okay, flaming the top of the tube like that is to keep any microorganisms that happen to be floating around in the air from contaminating your culture. So you're always going to flame the top of the tube. Take that loop full of bacteria, gently go into the tube, and just jiggle it around a little bit. Come out of the tube, remember to flame the top, put the lid on, set the new culture down. Remember there's bacteria on this loop, so sterilize your loop before you go on with any other steps or before you lay it on the bench. Okay, so that is sterile now, and lay it on the bench. So that is your first transfer of Bacillus subtilis broth to a new nutrient out of a nutrient broth. Okay, it's a liquid broth. So let's put those aside. The next transfer is a nutrient auger slant that has Bacillus subtilis on it to a new nutrient auger slant. Okay, so a nutrient auger slant is auger that has simply been allowed to solidify at an angle. It gives it a larger surface area inside the tube to grow bacteria. When you use an auger slant, you should use it so that you can see the surface. It's horizontal, gives you the best way of reaching the bacteria on it and again inoculating the next tube. Okay, so again, sterilize your loop. Okay, remember it's hot. Pick up your existing culture of it on the nutrient auger slant, Bacillus subtilis. Take the lid off, flame the top, go in, make sure you cool the loop. Okay, you should have the outer surface horizontal so that you can go in there and easily just scrape a little bit of bacteria. You don't need a lot. There's millions of cells in a tiny amount. Okay, so you'll see there's a tiny bit amount on the end of the loop. Flame the top, put the lid back on, put it back in the rack. Pick up the new tube, which remember you have labeled accurately. With the microorganism, the date, and your initials. Make sure you turn it so that the outer slant is horizontal, the easiest to work with. Remove the lid, flame the top, take this bacteria that you have on the loop, and then gently zigzag it up to the surface of that outer. Try not to dig into the outer. It's only like jello, so it's easy to dig into, but be gentle. Then flame the top, put the lid on, set that down. Remember there's bacteria on this loop. So flame the loop before you go on, before you lay it on the lab bench. Okay, so now you have created a new outer slant of Bacillus subtilis. We'll put those aside. So our last transfer is a Bacillus subtilis plate to a new nutrient outer plate. A nutrient auger is a very common media. It will grow any type of microorganism. So you will see us using this a lot. A nutrient auger is the same thing these slants are made out of. And a nutrient broth is the same thing except it doesn't have the auger in it, so that it is liquid. So back to the plates. So you have an existing culture on a nutrient auger plate of Bacillus subtilis. And you have a new plate of nutrient auger. When you use plates, you use them lid down. When you label plates, you label the bottom where the auger is. Never label the lid. The lid, again, can get switched very easily. Label the bottom with the microorganism, the date, and your initials. And you should label it around the edges because that way you can see better what's in the middle if that is something that you need to do. Okay? Use them lid down. It's much easier than the old methods of trying to open the lid up and work underneath the lid without getting any contamination. So, lid down, pick it up. You can see it's very easy to see the bacteria and work with it this way. So, you have your inoculating loop. Sterilize it so it's red hot for a few seconds. And then you will pick up the plate that has the bacteria on it. Again, the lid remains on the counter. You just pick up the bottom so you can access the bacteria very easily. This is hot, okay? So what you want to do to cool it this time is, again, don't point this plate towards your face. Point it away. And cool it where there is no bacteria. You'll be able to see because bacteria is very obvious on the outer surface. Cool it where there isn't any bacteria. And again, you'll hear a little and that's fine. After you cool it, use that loop to take a little bit of the bacterial culture off of the surface of the outer. You set that plate back down. Pick up the new plate. Notice you don't flame these. These are plastic. Okay, you're simply going to pick the plate up. You have bacteria on your loop. Just take that bacteria and just, for this time, not doing anything special, just make a zigzag across the surface of the outer. And this is where, if you have that little crook in the end of your inoculating loop, it lets you skate right along the surface because you don't want to dig into the outer. Remember, it only has the consistency of jello. Okay, so just zigzag along the surface. Put the plate back down. Remember, there's bacteria on here. So you have to sterilize before you set it down. Okay, so now we have completed a new subculture of Bacillus subtilis on a nutrient auger plate and a nutrient broth and a nutrient auger slant. We will incubate these for 24 to 48 hours at 37 degrees Celsius and then come back to the lab after that point and see if we have growth. If we have growth, we have succeeded in transferring bacteria. Hopefully we have only succeeded in transferring the bacteria we wanted to, which was the Bacillus subtilis. There should be only one species of bacteria, the Bacillus subtilis, in the new cultures. If there are other species in the culture, it is contaminated, and we did not do asepting technique successfully. Okay, we did not do the process of moving our bacteria that we would have wanted to move from one location to the other without contamination, so we weren't successful. Okay, so that is our lesson for aseptic technique.